Hi everyone. So let's call it abstract class. Abstract is a simple class which is having the method without definition. So let's call it as a fake class. I just have a fake class came into my mind. Public static m1, and this is of type string. Okay. And another thing is we have public static f1, this is a function name, and this function is returning void. Okay, so this is an abstract class. Okay, and the condition that abstract class would have either static or abstract methods inside it. So now you can see this abstract class is having static members, right? So I can access them directly. You can see f1, I can directly access, or m1. I can directly access, because those are the static. So 90 is not assignable to that. Okay, it's a type string, right? So obviously hello, right? So class can have a static members, like class is a static class. So this class will have a, let's talk about the static variables, public static, and this is the variable I'm creating of type number. And then I can also have a private static method, private static number of also type number. Number is small. Okay, so now let's talk about the class, how, what all different things you can access. Dot PA. Yeah, you can access it because this is a public. Now static class dot private static, right? You cannot access it because this is the private variable. Even if you try to access it or try to assign something, then you will get an error, right? Property private static is private and only accessible within the class. So you can create a public function where you can access it. So this is how we declare the static methods, inside static methods and static variables inside the class. So public static variables are accessible outside the class, like static class dot PA, but private static variables are not accessible outside the class. So there is no point of creating the private static variables. Okay. Now, so next thing we will talk about is class private constructor. So you can also create a class having the private constructor. And what is the use of it? Because there is, if you are creating the private constructor, then obviously you cannot create, you cannot instantiate the object of this class from outside. So this is valid, but like const obj equal to new, right? Here you will cannot find, oh sorry, what I'm doing. But this is the class name. So constructor of the class private is a private, only accessible within the class declaration. So this is it. You cannot create the instance like this from the outside of the class. So this particular use case we can use to create a singleton kind of pattern, right? Singleton pattern, what the singleton pattern says, that class would have only single object, right? Let's create that. Singleton class. This video is little heavy because it's going to take more time. Here I have a private static instance of a class. This is a private static instance of a class, and the type of this is a singleton class. Okay, now I have a private constructor. Inside the private constructor, what I'm doing is I'm trying to singleton class dot instance, I'm trying to assign the singleton class dot instance to some value. And you can, you know that if the class constructor is private. You cannot create the object outside the class. So I will try to do something here. So I'm trying to create an object, right? And here I have one public method to expose this, because the outside world need to get the instance of your class. So I will create a static method, get instance, and that get instance will expose this particular instance which we just created from the constructor. And what it is returning? Single instance class instance. Okay, and you can see, you will like it, whatever we are doing, this is singleton class dot instance. This is the actual view of creating a singleton class. Now from outside, obviously you cannot create the instance. So what you will do, singleton class, so I const instance, so singleton class, I don't want to create an instance because it's a private constructor, but I can call this public static method get instance, and what it is going to give you, it will give you the singleton instance of this particular class, right? Static instance is a static variable, so you can access it from the class name. So everywhere you can see singleton class dot instance, and I created the object here in the private constructor itself, and I created a public function to expose that instance which we received, right? So this is the pure singleton way of creating the instance of a class.